Hi, welcome to Full Frontal. I'm Samantha B. As we continue to live through the NyQuil nightmare that is 2020, it's easy to believe that God said he was going out for a pack of cigarettes and then just never came home. Yet, as bad as this year has been, the Supreme Court recently handed down a decision that was a major victory for the LGBTQ community and one that also made my body go, double up,
A historic ruling from the U.S. Supreme Court today outlawing job discrimination on the basis of sexual orientation or transgender identity.
I've read the decision and some people were surprised, but they've ruled and we live with their decision. That's what it's all about.
The court's decision basically means that the sex part of the prohibiting discrimination because of sex language in the Civil Rights Act also applies to sexual orientation and gender identity.
Gorsuch brushed aside the Trump administration's argument that the Civil Rights Act of 1964 was not written with gay and transgender people in mind. An employer who fires an individual for being homosexual or transgender fires that person for traits or actions it would not have questioned in members of a different sex. Sex plays a necessary and undisguisable role in the decision, exactly what the law forbids.
Which is interesting, since Gorsuch is way more familiar with disguisable roles, given all the times he's nearly foiled those muddling kids. The Supreme Court's decision is good news, but there's far more we need to be doing to protect transgender people. It's still incredibly difficult to be trans in America, particularly if you're Black. And Black trans women have it especially bad.
Black trans women face what activists call triple marginalization, confronting racism, sexism, and transphobia.
Transgender women of color, particularly Black transgender women, are disproportionately affected by fatal violence impacted by the intersections of racism, sexism, homophobia, biphobia, and transphobia.
The only way to make that intersection worse is if there were actual street signs reading racism, sexism, homophobia, biphobia, and transphobia, especially if you live there. Even within the larger LGBTQ community, transgender people have faced discrimination and exclusion, despite the fact that they've been fighting for a gay liberation from the beginning. Black trans women helped build the Black Lives Matter movement and played a pivotal role in the Stonewall riots. But white people are so good at appropriating, we made ourselves the stars of a movie about it. That's right, white people. If we're not in it, we're not seeing it. Trans women of color have been excluded from the stories of the movements they created. And while their fight is just now getting attention, they've been doing the work to fight against this larger culture of transphobia for decades.
The transgender community is oftentimes marginalized in America. Our stories unheard, dismissed, and discarded.
I've been followed home. I've been stalked. I've had guys try to sexually harass me in just disrespectful ways.
We wake up in a world that is not designed to support transgender people, to welcome us in school, to give us a chance to get an education. Employers are not eager to hire us.
That is truly horrible. The only reason an employer should ever not be eager to hire you is if you walk back in after the interview and say, your bathroom's out of toilet paper. Can't get that resume back? And that is why I did not get The Daily Show. Trans people experience harassment and prejudice at home, school, and work, and they're also routinely misgendered and referred to by their given names or dead names by the press and authorities. Even in some women's movements, trans women are left out by trans-exclusionary radical feminists, or TERFs, who hatefully argue that trans women aren't real women. To which I say to J.K. Rowling, silencio, you cruel, rich dick. Trans women are women, and if you disagree, you're not a feminist. J.K. Rowling's stance is deeply disappointing, especially because of her impact on children. It's like if Beverly Cleary released a book titled The Mouse and the Motorcycle and the Blue Lives Matter. Transgender people of color face higher rates of poverty, violence, HIV infection, and 41% of Black trans people report that they have experienced homelessness at some point in their lives. Those are the most shocking statistics I've heard in recent memory, which is saying a lot, since just last week, my 6-year-old daughter informed me that she is 100% that bitch. What's a mother to do? While the Supreme Court's ruling may have protected transgender people in the workplace, 28 states still haven't expanded hate crime laws to protect trans people. And there are still bathroom bills on the floor that prevent trans people from using restrooms that match their gender identity. Bathroom bills are stupid and offensive and unnecessary. I mean, except for my bathroom bill, which is a man named Bill who holds my newspaper for me so I don't have to touch it. And even in New York, a state that prides itself on being progressive, there's an anti-sex worker law that, in addition to being terrible on its own, has the awful side effect of profiling trans women. Commonly called the walking while trans law, trans women are getting arrested just for walking down the street. Walking should never be a crime. And while we're at it, skateboarding should never be a crime either. Come at me, narcs! And if local governments are making life a living hell for trans people, the Trump administration is waging a full-on war. With a new rule, Trump recently removed protections from the Affordable Care Act that ensured healthcare providers can't discriminate against trans people. Trans people already have massive barriers to accessing quality healthcare, which, added to the racial health disparities exacerbated by coronavirus, means that Black trans people have it even harder. And just as terrible, an upcoming Department of Housing and Urban Development proposal will allow single-sex shelters to refuse to accommodate trans people.
When you have a single-sex shelter, and it's there specifically for women who are abused, and then people come in who do not appear to be women, but they say they're women, and you have to accept them, does that impinge upon the rights of those women?
No! Providing safe homes and shelter for people who need them is literally Ben Carson's whole job, especially since he hasn't had an acting gig since the movie Stuck on You. If you liked this video, hit subscribe and let me know in the comments below. And if you didn't like this video, I'm sure you've already left a comment. Thank you so much!